Sairam, my dear students, you have studied Indian freedom struggle in your primary school. I mean, especially in 6th and 7th standards. Shall I ask a very simple question? When did India attain freedom? Your answer is very simple. I know that you will say that 15th August 1947. See, after a long struggle, we were able to get independence. But soon after independence, we had to face so many problems. Could you list out the problems which we had faced soon after independence? Yes, India had to face many problems soon after independence. First one is rehabilitating the refugees who migrated from Pakistan. Pakistan mean here East Pakistan and West Pakistan. The East Pakistan today called as Bangladesh. Rehabilitating refugees who migrated from Pakistan. So many people, they started to migrate towards India. We had to assist by providing fundamental and basic amenities like food, shelter, education and health. Rehabilitating, restoring and merger of princely states. First point is, we had to, soon after the independence, we had to face the problem of rehabilitation. The second point is the merger of princely states. This was one of the challenges we had to face. See, there were 562 princely states. They are all independent rulers. They were not ready to join Indian Union because they were enjoying the privileges. They were enjoying the kingship. They are not ready to give up their kingship. That was also one of the challenges. That means merger of princely states. How many princely states were there? Today's first question for your exercise. And one more challenge, maintenance of law and order are the challenges during the beginning of independence. Third one is maintenance of law and order. See, this was successfully achieved. Sardar Patel, the Iron Man of India, Sardar Patel successfully achieved the merging process. That means he completed the task of merger of princely states and provinces with the Indian Union. And another challenge was maintenance of law and order. To maintain the law and order, we need law. From where we can get? From the Constitution. Today, we are going to see the lesson Indian Constitution. That means our Constitution. What do you mean by Constitution? The second question. We created a constitution. Even the challenge of framing a constitution in order to enable us govern the country was also fulfilled. How? Now let us know about the structure of our constitution, its characteristics, and about the fundamental rights and duties which mentioned in our constitution. Being a people of this country, being a citizen of this country, It is our duty to know the common ideas and some basic things of our constitution. Then only we become a aware citizen. Aware means here a responsible citizen. Now, before we are going to see the characteristics and fundamental duties, it was formed and framed. But what is, you know that Indian constitution is the elephantine constitution, lengthiest constitution. Our members of Constituent Assembly strived hard to frame such a wonderful constitution. Before we are going to see the characteristics and fundamental duties of this constitution, let us see the Indian Constituent Assembly. Indian Constituent. An assembly, a committee was framed. It included experts, stalwarts, political thinkers, economic thinkers. I mean, economists were included. Now we are going to see the Indian Constituent Assembly. In the beginning only, I asked the second question, what do you mean by constitution? To govern ourselves, to govern our country, we need set of rules and regulations. That means law. The constitution included that. Constitution is a set of rules and regulations guiding the administration of a state. This is called constitution. See, the recommendations of Motilal Nehru Committee and the decisions taken by the meeting of the National Congress, which held at Karachi in 1939, emphasized the need for the formation of Constituent Assembly. See, two committees, one is headed by Motilal Nehru and another one is the assembly which held at Karachi in 1939. Both recommended to form Constituent Assembly, the Indian Constituent Assembly. Yes. As per the recommendation of the Cabinet Commission, a Constitution Assembly with Indian members was formed in 1946. In 1946. The Assembly had 389 members. 389 members. Which committee recommended to form Constituent Assembly? Cabinet Commission. The fourth question was, when was Constituent Assembly formed? Third question. The fourth question is, how many members were there in the Indian Constituent Assembly? Indian Constituent Assembly. With the partition of India, the total number came down to 299. Formerly there were 389 members were there, but it was reduced to 299. There were 7 members from Mysore princely states, that means from Karnataka. The first meeting of the new Constituent Assembly held, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar was here, the chairman of the drafting committee. The first meeting of the new Constituent Assembly held on 9th December 1946. The next meeting was on 11th December 1946 under the chairmanship of Dr. Rajendra Prasad. Here, eminent persons like Jawaharlal Nehru, Sardar Vallabhai Bhai Patel, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, Maulana Abdul Kalam Azad, C. Rajagopalachari, K.M. Munshi, T.T. Krishnamachari, Srimati Sarojini Naidu, Srimati Sucheta Kripalani attended the meeting. The prominent stalwarts attended. Here I mentioned there were 7 members from Mysore princely states. Mention the prominent 7 members from who were part of Constant Assembly from Mysore princely states. From prominent people from Karnataka are S. Nijalingappa, K. C. Reddy, K. Chengalraya Reddy, Kengal Hanumanthayya, Tekur Subramanya, and others were also present in this Constant Assembly. And you can see the image of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. He was called as the architect of Indian Constitution. A scholar, an economist, a political thinker, and voracious reader. He was the first person to get PhD from Columbia University. Indian, he was the first Indian. And he played a noble role in 1935 Indian Act. And he suggested to form Reserve Bank of India. Okay, these are all out of box, but he was responsible to create such a wonderful constitution. That is Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. And one more person we have to remember, it is none other than Dr. Rajendra Prasad. He was the first president of India and he was the chairman and president of Constant Assembly also. Then Jawaharlal Nehru, the first prime minister of India, and he was the architect of Indian foreign policy too. See, he says, failure comes only when we forget our ideals and objectives and principles. Jawaharlal Nehru. Now, let us see drafting committee. In the Constant Assembly, there was drafting committee was there. That drafting committee, the Constant Assembly formed 12 committees and 5 subcommittees to examine all the details, all the issues related to the country. Why? Why they take care? Why they take that much of care? See, India is a subcontinent. Here you can see more than 1,000 languages, various communities, various diversities. It is very difficult to form a single constitution for diversified people. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar was the chairman of one of the most important committees, that is the drafting committee. Here, drafting committee played a prominent role. Drafting committee. And the Constant Assembly formed 12 committees. Out of that, drafting committee is one of the prominent committee. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar was the chairman of one of the most important committees, that is drafting committee, I told already, based on his contribution to the framing of the constitution. He is called as chief architect of Indian constitution. My sixth question is, who is the chief architect of Indian constitution? Who is the chief architect of Indian constitution? Now let us see other members of drafting committee are N. Gopalaswamy Iyengar, Alladi Krishnaswamy Iyer, K. M. Munshi, T. T. Krishnamachari, and some other eminent statesmen, eminent scholars. See, T. T. Krishnamachari, Alladi Krishnaswamy Iyer, and K. Munshi, they were also freedom fighter also. They were freedom fighter too. After that, the Constant Assembly took 11 months, 18 days to complete the task. During these discussions, various laws enacted by British government in 1901, 1919, 1935, the British parliamentary system, the American Bill of Rights, then social directive policies of Ireland were studied. And some elements of those were incorporated. Incorporated means we adopted, we have adopted. The Indian Constitution was approved on 26th November 1949. See, while framing the Constitution, the framers of our Constitution went through various constitutions. American Bill of Rights, the parliamentary system of America and parliamentary system of, British, then social directive policies of Ireland were studied, and we incorporated, we borrowed those ideas and adopted those ideas in our Constitution. Finally, our Indian Constitution was approved on 26th November 1949 and came into force on 26th January 1950. Why they choose 26th January? See, in the Lahore session which held in 1929, January 26, there they declared Purna Swaraj, Purna Swaraj. In memory of that day, they celebrated and our Constitution came into force the same day. That day is celebrated as Republic Day. One of the best features of our Constitution is preamble. Preamble. This is one of the best features of our Constitution. Now we are going to see the preamble to the Constitution or preamble of the Constitution. The Indian Constitution has combined in itself the best features of different constitutions of the world and as its own preamble also. Preamble you can see only in Indian Constitution. Though we have borrowed so lot of ideas from various constitutions like American Constitution, Britain Constitution, Ireland Constitution, Canadian Constitution, we have our own preamble. Preamble contains the fundamental policies and ideals of the Constitution. It is sum of the structure. See, if you want to know what is the Indian Constitution contained, if you go through the preamble, you can form an idea. You can get an idea what is there inside the Constitution. In the sum of the structure, values, principles, goals of the Constitution can be seen in preamble. It is based on the aspirations and ideals of the people of India. See, it is referred very beautiful thing. It is very clear sign of the democracy. It is, see, whatever it mentioned on the preamble, it says it is based on the aspirations and ideals of the people of India. It is not the aspiration of any political party. It is not aspiration of any political community. It is not part of any family. It says the aspirations and ideals of the people of India. See, this is the very beginning of democracy. The very basic idea of democracy. The preamble is a part of the objective resolution. See, resolution, a commitment, objective resolution, which was put forwarded by Jawaharlal Nehru on December 13, 1946 and approved by the Constituent Assembly on January 22nd, 1947. This resolution, see, who suggested? Jawaharlal Nehru suggested to adapt preamble in our Constitution. Even that was approved and adapted. The resolution upholds the nature of India's sovereign, democratic, republic nature. See, India is a sovereign country. India is a democratic country. India is a republic in nature. Then it also upholds social, economic, political justice for all. For all means all people, and all people is upheld. Social, economic and political justice. The preamble to our constitution is meaningful. How can you say? It describes our political system and is a key to understand constitution. Already I mentioned, if you want to know, if you want to understand constitution, you should go through preamble. While reading preamble, you can make out what does it contain. And it has been described as the jewel of the constitution. See, preamble is considered as the jewel of K. Munshi has referred the preamble as a political horoscope. What did K. Munshi say about the preamble, about the preamble of Indian constitution? Once again, what did K. Munshi say about the preamble of Indian constitution? Seventh question. He says it is a political horoscope. K. Munshi again is a political thinker, a great writer. We the Indian citizens, see, now let us see what does it say. We the Indian citizens, preamble of the constitution begins with we the citizens of India. The Indian constitution is framed by the Indians. It strives to fulfill the dreams of Indians. See, and it says sovereign, socialist, secular country. Dear children, today we discuss it. What are the challenges India had to face soon after independence? First one, in that, rehabilitation of migrants from Pakistan. Second one is merging process of the princely states. Third one is drafting constitution for this big country. In that constitution, then in that constituent assembly, the prominent members from Mysore princely states, then preamble. In that preamble, what does it say and what does K. Munshi say? All the fact about the things were discussed. Dear students, go through video along with the textbook. Keep textbook beside you. If you have any doubt, you can clear while going the lesson only. So that is why I am suggesting, go through the textbook while you watching the video. Sai Ram.